for the request of the son of Henry G. Russell, who was a young member of our parish family. She passed away last week. Let's pray for her, G. Russell. And this message offered for Alice and thy family. Let's pray for a moment. Lord, we pray for our nation and all the nations and all our brothers and sisters all over the world, those who are suffering from COVID-19 and various diseases and disasters. Please pray for my beloved sister, Jinsy. She's again hospitalized. And cancer is affecting her spine, and she's getting weak on her legs. Please do pray for her. Let's pray for our parish family, our family. lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Thank you.
the law, the worship, and the promises. Theirs the patriarchs, and from them, according to the flesh, is Christ, who is over all, God blessed forever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
My mother's younger sister, her name, she's
69. She is now in her 50s. And she is now suffering from cancer. For colorectal cancer. So it will be painful. Anyway, please keep her also in prayer. Her name is Sister Redfall. My dear friends, the theme of the day is God's ever saving presence and His Spirit. God of everlasting mercy is ever present in our lives. He listens to us. He answers our prayers. He speaks to us, and He is always close to us. And also speak of our need of trusting faith in loving God. And our need for prayer in our storms of life. The first reading reminds us to experience God's presence in tiny whispering sound. Experience the presence of God in tiny whispering voice. Elijah expected spectacular miracle from the Lord, revealing Himself in strong wind, earthquake, and fire. But Jesus' Lord was present in tiny whispering sound. Like Elijah, so often we look in the wrong places for God's presence. Let's seek our Lord in small things and tiny events of our daily life. Why does Lord present in tiny whispering sound? God's whisper means that we have to move closer to Him to hear Him. Then we can find the answers to our prayers, and we can feel the closest presence of the Lord. Our merciful Lord is whispering in our ears, "I love you, and I am with you in the midst of all your sorrows and sufferings of life. I will save you. I will feed you." Let's listen to God's whispering voice. Matthew's Gospel presents two miracles on the sea. In the first event, Jesus was sleeping in the boat. And in the second event, Jesus was walking on water. Today's Gospel begins by reminding us that Jesus was not on the boat. The wind was against it. We may have plenty of such Jesus was sleeping on the boat. Or Jesus was not in the boat. Or the wind was against us experiences in our daily life when we face various storms of life, storms of temptations, weaknesses, and addictions, the storms of various crises, confusions, and conflicts, storms of various fears and frustrations, anxieties and tensions about our future, the storms of various diseases, disasters, and our conditions of life, especially of the present COVID pandemic situations. Many storms in our family The winds and the waves are sometimes against us. All of us have such experience in our life. And we may have also, like Peter, the doubting or sinking into deep sea moments in our life. Or the times of distancing of us, oh, you are in faith. Why did you doubt? All of us have many doubting and sinking moments in our life. Peter represents us that we believe in God and take our first step in confidence, but all of a sudden we take our eyes off Jesus, or we fail to fix our eyes on Jesus, and we are tempted to look down at the storms of life. Thus, we sink into the depth of human failures and fears. We might even fear of ourselves. We may get terrified and frightened like Peter in the midst of various tides, waves, and winds of difficulties. We may be tempted to shrink away or run away, or even hide because of our fear of shame or rejection, or our fear of unwantedness or unworthiness. So, let's fix our eyes on Jesus, and let's pray loudly and deeply from our heart the prayer of Saint Peter. The prayer of Saint Peter. Peter said, "Lord, save me." Lord, save me. Or the prayer of the Canaanite woman. She said, "Lord, help me. Have pity on me." Or the blind man's prayer. "Lord, have mercy on me, a sinner." Lord, have mercy on me, a sinner. So let us do the prayer of Saint Peter. Lord, save me. And today, Jesus, stretching out his hands, says to us, "Take courage, it's I, do not be afraid." Knowing all our pains and tears of life, all our confusions and uncertainties of life, Jesus tells us, "Take courage, it is I, do not be afraid, do not be afraid." Jesus here appears as our champion, our savior, our shepherd, and our shepherd. And Jesus gives us courage, strength, and confidence and comfort in times of all our storms of life. Jesus is near to us to protect us, take care of us, and save and heal us when it comes to our death at our sinking and stumbling moments of life. When Jesus got into the bar, the wind died down. Praise the Lord. When Jesus got into the bar, the wind died down. So let us invite Jesus into our life. Lord, come to our life. Then Jesus will come to us and will help us. Take it's time, do not be afraid. Jesus Christ, stretching out his sacrificing and saving hands on the cross and shedding the last drop of blood for us, tells us, "This much I love. This much I love. Take courage. It's time, do not be afraid." And the priest is calling a priest. Our merciful Lord is the champion and captain of the boat of our life. He knows everything, and He answers for our prayers. He is our strength, savior, shelter, and healer. Let's gather all our prayers to the hands of the Lord.
In today's gospel, we read how Jesus walked on the waters so that the apostles might recognize him as the Christ and believe in him. We pray that our faith be strong and never falter, even when faced with stormy
God the Father of mercies, come to our help and save and feed us, and give us the strength and courage to face and win over the various storms, winds, and waves of life are against us. Lord, give us to take courage in you. Lord, be with us in the midst of all our sorrows, sufferings, pains, and tears of life. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Blessed are you, Lord God, for creation, for the goodness we have received, the bread we offered, fruit of the earth, and open hands, it will become for us bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of our creation, for the goodness we have received, the wine we offer, fruit of the vine, and our hands, it will be our spiritual drink. God before my dear Father.
May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and for all of the Lord's church.
Lord, be pleased, O Lord, to accept the offerings of your church, for in your mercy you have given them to be offered, and by your power you transform them into the victory of our salvation. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let's give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty of salvation, our best return, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. Our God, for by his word he renewed humanity's fallen state, and by his suffering cancelled out our sins, and he is rising from the dead, he has opened the way to the life, and by ascending to your Father, he has unlocked the gates of heaven. And so with all the angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise as we have been.
Thank you.
The mystery of faith.
The Savior's command and informed by
mystery grant this in our days, that by your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from our distress as we await blessed hope the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom of
before the Lamb of God, before the King, who takes away the sins of the world, blessed are those who are supper of the Lamb.
Thank you.
Bless thy brother, O sacrament and most holy,
O sacrament and mine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment of mine. We believe in Jesus Christ, the worthy, truly, and substantial person, born of the Queen, body and blood, soul and divinity, O sacrament and most holy, O sacrament and mine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment of mine.
My dear brothers and sisters, thank you all of you for being here for this holiness. Thank you so much, my angels, Mary and Will, my choir, Steve and Eric, and Mark Miller, Maureen, Job and Bruce, and thank you for all of you. Thank you, honey and cake. Thank you for all of you once again. God bless you. Please bless you for prayer. And the communion in your sacrament that we have received, save us, O Lord, and convert us in the light of the truth through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be
with you. And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace and joy, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Please continue your prayers for my sister DC and sister Vero. I have not any chance now to fly to India. We have not fly to India. Our airports are closed and no chance to fly to Philippines. So what we can do? Only one thing, pray. So let's pray, pray, and pray. God bless you.
Our reception.